गुड मॉर्निंग एंजॉयिंग क्लास, वेलकम टू द ड्राइंग क्लास। एज यू ऑल नो, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी एंड न्यूट्रल कलर्स इन द कॉपी। नाउ टुडे आई विल टेल यू योर बुक वर्क। सो फर्स्ट पेज इन योर ड्राइंग बुक इज योर पेज नंबर 10, पेज नंबर 10 एंड 11, दैट इज योर ऑब्जेक्ट ड्राइंग। ओके, बिफोर दैट इट इज ऑल रिलेटेड टू प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी एंड न्यूट्रल कलर दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन। सो इन दिस पेज वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस। गाइडलाइंस आर दीज डॉटेड लाइन्स विच आर देयर टू हेल्प यू टू कम्प्लीट द पिक्चर। It is written here to complete the picture and darken it with black pen. So you all will not use black pen in the copy. You will only use pencil. So first of all, take help of the guidelines. This dotted line which are required, those dotted lines only you will take and rest you will not touch. Suppose this is the center line given for the lamp. We will draw this side and this side line to give the thickness to the lamp and complete the shape of the lamp this way. We will not do it with black pen after this. Now come to the next drawing, that is your fan. You can see guidelines are given for this also. This is the center line. I will draw this line and this line. From the center line I will take little bit this side and this side and then draw this shape. Then you can see the oval shape here. This is double line, and here where the wings of the fan is there, there is a small line for connectivity that you have to draw. Now come to the scissor. In the scissor, as you can see, dotted lines are again given. The inside circle is like this, the outer one is there where you have to give the shape. Like this you will complete the drawing of the scissor. Take the help of the guidelines which are not required. You will not touch those guidelines. Okay, give the proper shape with pencil only and then darken it with pencil only. Don't use pen to darken it like this. Now come to the next, that is your pot. This center line is given. I have given the shape this way and this way. This line you will draw and then give the shape like this. Whichever is not required, you will not highlight that part. Now come to the next, that is your bulb. Again center line is given here. This circle will be always there in the center or the middle. Then two circles this side and then join them together like this. Follow the center point, then always it will come in center and proportionate drawing you will get. Now this part is little bit round, the corners are little bit round. Everything you will draw with pencil only. Now come to the next drawing, that is your mug. Again take the help of the guidelines. Whichever lines are highlighted or required, only those lines you will highlight. Rest lines you will not touch. Make the handle this way. This part again dotted line is given for the inside one. Like this you will do, and then this part is already given. The outer one you will draw on your own. So this way you have to complete the object drawing page, that is your page number 10 and 11. Now come to the next page that is there in your book, is 12 and 13 is not in syllabi. Now come to the next, that is your 14 and 15. Write down date and classwork on page number 14 and 15. And in this it is object drawing flowers. Again it is written to shade it with black pen. So it is optional. If you wish, you can do, or you can use shading pencil only to highlight this. So the first flower that we have to draw is hibiscus. Guidelines are again given here. Hibiscus is having 5 petals Here only four petals are visible, so we will draw those four only. So we will start the drawing this way, taking help of the guidelines like this. The first petal you will draw, then take the help of the guidelines and then draw the second petal this way. Then you have the third one this side. You will take help of the guidelines this way, third one, and the fourth one is this. Fifth is not visible, it's at the back. This is the middle part. This we will draw. It has having two lines, double lines like this. I will draw at the end one circle, then small lines like this. I will draw this side and put circles at the end. Like this with the pencil only. You can use 2B, 4B and 6B pencils gradually to give the shading. Wherever you have to give dark tone, there you can use 6B pencil. Or suppose if you are not having shading pencil, you can use the same pencil, but when you are using it, the pressure should be different. Like wherever you need the light tone, there you will press the pencil lighter. Wherever you need little bit darker tone, the same pencil you will press little bit harder. So you will get the shaded effect like this. The first petal I am doing the shading part. Shading can be done with two ways. Either you can do with lines like this, in which the lines are visible, and suppose you want mixing, then you will do it this way. So in this, lines are not visible. So it is up to you which way you want to shade or highlight your flowers. So pressing the pencil by hard or soft, you will get different tones. Or you can use different tones, different shading pencils also to get the shaded effect. Now like this you will complete your hibiscus flower. Each petal you have to shade like this. It will take some time to complete. So like this you will complete. Now this one, the center part is darker, so you will darken the center part, then the edges. Give the shading this way in this petal also. Now make the stem and the leaves. There is one bud also given, so we will make the bud also. Shade it. Now draw the leaf. Now the center line, the veins, and then shade it. Like this, you have to complete the flower. Write down date and classwork on the page when you start, and don't use pen. Now come to the next flower, that is your sunflower. In the sunflower, again the dotted lines are given. Whichever line is given there, you will take it, this dotted line you will take it as center, and then draw the leaf like this. So in this way you will keep on drawing the leaf. Take the center line like this and then draw the leaf. Again take the center line, draw the leaf. This one, draw the leaf. Again, so whichever dotted lines are given, first you will draw there a centered leaf, and then in between draw one leaf complete the inner flower first. When inner flower is completed, then between these two main petals you will draw one half petal like this. So your sunflower will be ready this way. First draw dotted lines leaf, take it as center, then in between those two dotted lines draw the leaf. When the inner part is completed, then in between these two leaves draw one half leaf. Okay, like this you will complete and then give the shading. From inside to outside you will do the shading in the sunflower. From center to outside you can use shading pencil to do the shading. Like this you can do the shading. In each petal you can do the shading. Now we will draw the leaves. Draw the stem and the leaf. Again the dotted line is given. Cuts are there at the end of the leaf. You will draw the cuts, then draw the veins and then shade it. Both sides you will draw the leaf this way, cuts at the end of the leaf and then draw the veins and then shade it. So like this we will complete sunflower. Now come to the next one. This is your tulip. Again the guidelines are given, only little bit curve here you have to give in between these two. You have to draw these two leaves and then the center part. Leaves are having little bit curves at the end, so draw the curves. Don't draw a straight leaf. Curve should be there in the leaf and then the center line and the veins and then shaded. Now come to the lotus. See lotus. This guideline is given. One line is given here and one this. So we will start from the center petal. This one is given, so I will draw a leaf shape like this and the other half this. So the center leaf is there ready. Now one curve this side one leaf and then the other side opposite of it one leaf. Now one more leaf this side and one more leaf this side. It is ready. Now the lower part, so we will draw it like this. Now one leaf this side, the other leaf this side. Now in between these two one leaf. Now like this your lotus flower is ready. Now you have to shade it. Shading can be done from lower part to the upper part this way. Now this side we will do the shading. Now darken the ends and from the top you can do the shading this way. So like this complete the lotus flower shaded. Now we have to draw the leaf and the stem. Lotus leaf is little bit different from rest of the leaf. You know it floats on water. So the shape of lotus leaf is this whole oval shape is there, but one curve like this you will draw and then the center line and the lines like this and then you will shade it. So like this here you can draw a little bit of water also if you wish. This lotus is there in water. So like this you can draw and shade lotus leaf and like this you will complete your page number 14 and 15. That is your object drawing page. So page number 10 and 11 and 14 and 15 you will complete in your book. And then next week I will tell you two more pages. Thank you and have a nice day.